was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my sin. Hey! Till I met you. Come on, put your hands together. I was breathing the night. There we go.
Chains are gone, our days for the Lamb who was slain. He is real. Come on, church, sing it out. I give my whole life to honor this love. By the Lamb who was slain, oh, I'm forgiven. The sinner's Savior, crown him forever. For the Lamb who was slain, he is risen. I give my whole life to honor this love. By the Lamb who was slain, I'm forgiven. The sinner's Savior, crown him forever. For the Lamb who was slain, he is risen. Our chains are gone.
The day that death surrendered to the mighty cross of Jesus Christ, the earth would shake beneath the weight of darkened skies.
His brow, a crown of sorrow, for a king whose weakness was our strength. No word.
to me this morning, because for the first time in my life, I've sang worship songs where I understand a little more. We just got back from Israel, all of the Holy Land, and I've been telling people it should be a prerequisite to be a pastor. You should instead of 1 year of Bible college, go for 10 days to Israel, and it's a wrap. And it is safe, and I felt like I was in a bubble of not only protection, and there was nothing scary around us, but it is the enemy to keep us away. We live in a lifetime where Israel is free, where it's safe to go there, but to stand on one side of the grave, not one grave, but millions of graves, boxes of stone graves that go down a hillside, and on the other side you can see Jerusalem, the old and the new wall of Jerusalem, and to see a stone gate that's called the Golden Gates, that when Jesus returns, that gate will come apart and the new Jerusalem will be built right there for the new earth. And to go on a boat on the Sea of Galilee, now I get when we say or we sing certain things. So you need to make sure it's not on your bucket list for when you're like a couple years from the end of your life. You need to do whatever you can to get there. But what I will say is that the presence of God is so heavy, is so awesome, and is so light, and there's such peace, that since we got back 2 days ago, I have had a stomachache. Like, and it's not the food, because the food was really good and healthy, but a stomachache. And I realized that Satan was like, oh no, you don't get to walk forward and worship, understanding things more. You don't get to have a freedom to pray and believe God can do it because you actually saw where Jesus walked upstairs to the temple. Satan is going, I don't like what's happened in your life. And there are times that God does something awesome in your life, and Satan wants you to forget it so that when you have another need that you need prayer for, you just have a stomachache and think, how am I going to get through it? And Satan is winning when you think there's no way. But God has done something for you before. God can do something for you again. And that's what, when the worship started and you were in this place, my stomachache left. And I know that it has to do with the presence of God is thick when people are gathered together. And His presence is here. It goes with you. It comes with you. He's with you at all times. But there's something special about being in a place where we can worship, where we can pray, where we can pray with you and for you. So our prayer partners are coming now, and they're really that. They're prayer partners. They're partnering with you in prayer. So come during this last song of worship, and don't let, some of you did walk in with a gut ache, or you walked in with a headache, or you walked in with anxiety, or you walked in with a heavy heart. God will lift it, and He will do it now if He hasn't already. And so come during this last song of worship. Let us pray with you and for you.
Will not forget the message that doesn't just scream, that doesn't just shine me up, but changes the depths of me. I will not fall short on the journey that I am down. Mountains and valleys, full of pain, but yet full of hope. Jesus, my destiny, heaven be inside of me. Jesus, my victory, these honest words, let them be. A prayer to the Prince of Peace, a prayer to the Mercy King. I will not forget the message that doesn't just gleam, that doesn't just shine me up, but changes the depths of. Jesus, my destiny, heaven be. inside of me. Jesus, my victory. These honest words, let them be a prayer to the Prince of Peace, a prayer to the Mercy King. Prayer to a king who cares far more about my heart beating his heart. If you know this song, would you sing it out today? Let these steps that I take, come on. Make this our prayer today. Let these words say.